afternoon. I'd just like to thank everyone for coming along and all those involved in the parade of the bands and other vehicles, and especially the boys and girls in the front in the fancy dress. The Consul General of the United States of America with us, and he's going to plant a commemorative tree, and we'd ask people to gather around the stage by about 20 to 3 for the American National Anthem and for the speech by the Consul General. So until about a quarter to 3, please enjoy yourselves. We've come to support the Livingstonia Hospital in Malawi, and I know you'll be generous in your giving. So I'm going to invite the Derry Oak Flute Band just to play some music for us now, and feel free to circulate and enjoy yourselves. Thank you all for coming.
I'm just going over to the pantry. I'll put you down
much point. Can you get the cake for yourself? Thank you. Thank you.
that will remind us of this important event. We're going to be planting a rowan tree, which is just in the centre of our garden. And Mr. Pittman is going to be planting that in a few moments. Whenever that has been planted, we're going to have James Stevenson play the rowan tree, which is a little piece that probably many of you are familiar with on the bagpipes. But it gives me a great privilege and a great pleasure to welcome to Kilkeel this afternoon Mr. Dean Pittman, who is the US Consul General to Northern Ireland. Mr. Pittman comes from the state of Mississippi, and he is representing the President here in our country. And as he comes forward, the band's going to play the national anthem of the United States of America. So I ask you all please to be upstanding. Welcome our guest, and then we'll honour him with the American national anthem. So everyone just please stand and give a very warm Kilkeel welcome to Mr. Pittman.
Thank you, Ben. That was terrific. A great rendition of our Star Spangled Banner, and I certainly appreciate it today. I have to say, I almost feel like home with the national anthem, and I see the American flag flying over here, so it's awfully nice to be made to feel so welcome here, as I have been made to feel welcome in all of Northern Ireland. But it's not unique. As many of you know, Northern Ireland was the home to over 300,000 American soldiers during World War II. I think at the peak, 120,000 at one time was in Northern Ireland, and that's 10%. It's amazing to think 10% of your population were American soldiers, and apparently they behaved pretty well. I checked their consulate records, and I see that there were 1,800 weddings from GIs marrying local gals. So there's also 600 births, at least the ones that they reported. So it sounded like they had a good time and were well welcomed here. So that's a great privilege for me to be here. This year, as with the 60th anniversary of VE Day, has been particularly a privilege for me, because there were so many areas around Northern Ireland where U.S. soldiers made their home and were camped and based before they went to the war, either in North Africa or in Europe. And in every place, they were made to feel extremely welcome. And it is certainly not unusual, because, you know, as many of you probably know, probably about 45 million Americans claim some sort of connection with this island, either through the Ulster Scots connection or the Irish connection. It's hard to find an American who doesn't trace his roots back here. And as a result, the ties between our country and Northern Ireland remain and have always been very strong and very important. In fact, the consulate where I work and I represent the United States and President Bush is the second oldest consulate in the world. We opened in 1796, have been operating continuously ever since. I also note that the newsletter paper was the first paper in Europe to print the Declaration of Independence. That's where King George read about it for the first time. So that was another connection we have with the island. All in all, though, I have to say the ties between our country remain strong. We have a strong interest in seeing Northern Ireland prosper, have a stable and bright future, and we're here to do what we can and be a part of it. So again, I don't want to, I've seen that there's a lot of fun going on here. Hearing me speak probably is not the high point of it, but it's a delight to be here. And I'd also like to congratulate all the folks who've worked so hard on this day and commend you for the fundraising effort for the hospital in Livingstonia. And I think there's a group of about, the Reverend tells me about 20 going out again this year. So I want to wish them the best of luck. And so having two great events today, the celebration of VE Day and raising money for this terrific cause is terrific. And I'm very, very happy that I can be a part of it today. So I think with the Reverend's approval, we'll go plant a tree.
So we'll just get through here now.
Thank you.
turnout here.
Good turnout on a good day for us.
Good day for us, yeah.
Not too bright, it's not
too warm.
A good turnout.
Thank you.
course, the Derry Oak that were on just before that. We're now going to have the Kinkara School of Dancing. Now, the girls are going to be performing not on the stage, and the boys as well, but down below. So they're going to need a big, big space. So we're going to ask people just to move right the way back, please. And perhaps the folk who are on Siva moving back, please. That's good.
She's dancing anyway.
Thank you. have Chloe, Courtney and Jade, and they're going to perform one of the Scottish national dances, the lilt. She's going to perform the Flora. This is another of the national dances.
Thank you.
form the rain, the Highland rain.
Members of Ballymacheop accordion band to make their way onto the platform. I was going to say into the pulpit, but it's not really that. Now we're very pleased to have with us some other guests. We have two folk from Malawi. We have Binny and Dora, and I'm going to ask them to come forward along with Una, and perhaps just to join me for a few moments. Give them a very big warm welcome. That's Binny and Una from Livingstonia, Malawi, and Una. Here. If I may just introduce them. Binny, first of all, is a minister with the Central Church of Africa Presbyterian. He's been studying in Belfast for 2 years, and he's going to Livingstonia to look after the theological department at the university there. Dora, you have seen her picture on the display. Dora was the matron at the hospital in Livingstonia for many years. She's not there now. She's moved on. And Una Brownlee, everybody from Mourne will probably know Una because of our contact with her and her late husband out in the hospital there. I'm just going to ask one or two very brief questions. First of all, maybe Binny, can you tell us a little bit about the hospital in Livingstonia, what connection it is to the church?
Well, the hospital in Livingstonia came together with the missionaries who came to Livingstonia in 1894. So the church and the hospital are very much together. They are one and the same thing.
Dora, you worked in the pediatric unit that we helped build in Mourne. What does the commitment of the people of Mourne mean to the folk in Malawi?
It means a lot because in Livingstonia we were just combining a female and a children's ward. So the fact that we have a separate children's ward means a lot to Malawi because now we can nurse children more better than before.
And in the last word with you, would you like to say a word on behalf of all the staff? There you worked for many years in the David Gordon Memorial Hospital.
I would just like to say thank you very, very much to all the members of the work parties who have been and who are going to Livingstonia, to their families, to the congregation here in Mourne, and to the whole community who have supported the project so well. It really has been much appreciated and has been a tremendous encouragement to us who have been working there with the people. And the people have been really encouraged out there by their friendship and with the tremendous support that you have given. Thank you all very, very much.
Give them a big round of applause. Thank you. Just to remind you that we have Ballymajock Band on now just for a few moments, and then we have a puppet show for everyone, adults and boys and girls alike. And then we have an auction of promises. Now, there are lists of things going, there are lists of what is being auctioned going round. I'm told there's a booby prize going round. There's a signed T-shirt of Man United and nobody wants it. But that's going on at the very last. Okay, so over to Ballymajock Band. Yes.
Thank you. Jim.
Jim who?
My Jim. Yes. Hey. 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 You see that drawing?
Where?
Did you get anything?
That's right.
You got over the place.
Sure,
it
is here, please.
Somewhere like.
Mention again, what we're going to do is another chip-pan demonstration similar to what we've done this morning for those of you who missed it. This time, we might get it out. What we have is a chip-pan here that's left unattended. If you're doing this in your own home, you've got approximately 10 minutes before this chip-pan will cause serious damage to your home. It will ignite. It should be through in the bin. And that includes even your frying pan. It can also go into break into flames as well. The major cause of fires in the home is caused by chip pans, believe it or not, in Northern Ireland and the whole of the UK as a matter of fact. So we'll give it now probably about 8 to 10 minutes. And when it ignites, we'll show you how to put it out and how not to put it out. So if you just bear with us, thank you. As you see now, the chip pan has caught fire. Jeffrey's going to demonstrate one way you can put it out. But this should only be attended by adults. What happens to any of the younger folk is you get out of the house, close the door behind them, and phone the fire brigade. I'm going to attempt, the first attempt is with a fire blanket, which we should all have in our kitchen. Not covered in oil. Exactly. First of all, the extinguish the source of power to the pan. See, you see how hard it is. That's even with a fire blanket, but to be honest, folks, that fire blanket has been used so many times there's oil on it. But believe me, a new fire blanket will put that out.
That really is a silly attempt, isn't it? Everybody knows cloth burns that fire.
That's a special fire blanket.
That's what you wouldn't do is lift it up, but we've just done that to get it extinguished. The blankets will stay on, well, so stay on indefinitely, but at least for half an hour. If when you remove that blanket, the chances are that the pan will ignite again. As you see, another way, if we haven't got a fire blanket, we can use a damp, well-run out drying cloth. All right, then. Jeffrey's now going to demonstrate the drying cloth. It's every bit as good as the fire blanket, to be quite honest. There we go. And that's only one drying cloth. If it wasn't to work with the one, we could also apply another one. Jeffrey removes that again. Same thing's going to happen. It's going to ignite. Once he gets the source of air. And there we go. Now, the one thing we should never do, I think we should all know, is put water on an oil fire. And if you just hide your eyebrows a moment. That is what happens. You put water on an oil fire. Can you imagine that happening in your kitchen? House destroyed. So ladies and gentlemen, if you just remember, any chip pans you got should never be left unattended. Really, they should never be used. Well, I put it out, yeah, for the house's entire room. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our small demonstration. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
Wait a phone call. The pump, what's wrong with the pump, right? It's broken, right? I tell you what I'm going to do, right? I'm trained in this, don't worry. I know, I can fix this. Everyone knows when the pump breaks, you call the beggar, because the beggar can fix the pump, all right? I tell you what I'm going to do. I've got a breath here. I'm going to feed it to the pump. Brexit back this morning, by the way. Especially back this morning. I'm going to feed it to the pump. You think that'll work there? I'm going to give it a go anyway.
Come on, you boy.
Come on. The pump's not working.
Hey,
I'm going to
have to
go time
with
this one again. Sorry.
Oh, my goodness gracious me. Even the baker with a very annoying accent still couldn't fix the pump. So, what they decided to do next was call for the painter. Yeah. Maybe the painter could fix the pump. Hopefully this will work.
Well, what seems to be the problem here?
The pump's not working.
The pump's not working?
Mm-hmm.
Well, everyone knows when the pump's not working, you call the painter. And I've been painting all day, and I'm going to paint this pump and make it work.
Even the painter couldn't fix the pump. Then, all of a sudden, the little boy in the crowd shouted out loud, "You don't call for a painter or a baker to fix a pump. You call for a plumber." So, they called for a plumber, and this is what happened next.
Come forward, and William Turner as well, please. We come to the auction, so if anybody's interested in bidding for any of the things that are at the front here or on the sheep.
Is that Is this machine on, ladies and gentlemen? This is the highlight of the evening now. There's a number of things here that have to be sold. And me, assisted by my beautiful assistant here, Miss Jenna Hanna, will endeavour to do it. Any offers for this portable CD player? Any offers? The same photograph. Any offers? Any offers for it? Some of you boys that's at the archery. What? A fiver, a good price. £5 I'm offered here. £5 for a signed photograph of Tony Blair. £10. I can't see him. £12 on. Not a lot of them about either. You know? £12 over my left for a signed autograph, a signed photograph. £12 going once. £12 will be writing and telling him what he's worth now. £12. £12 on my left going the third and last time. He with this big tongue. What do you call him? Our pianist's husband. And now a framed photograph. Now you'll notice it is by Arthur Gervin, not of Arthur Gervin. A signed photograph, a framed photograph by Arthur Gervin. Have any of you anything you want framed? Any overs? Oh, the photograph knows there, I thought it was a frame, sorry. Photograph here, any overs for it? Any overs? Any overs? Where is it off? Right, I'll give £20. £20 for it. £20. Any advance in 20? 20. Sure the frame's worth twice it. Quick. Any advance in £20? 25. £25. Over 30. £30. £30. 5. 35. Andrew, where are you at? Get up. 40. £40 away down in the middle. For the signed or for the framed photograph here. £40 down here in front. £40. Any advance in 40 away down here on my left. £40 going once. £40, 5. 45, Andrew, jump up again. 45, this is all for a very good cause, you know. Don't be so miserable. £45 on my left. £45 going once. £45 going twice. £45 on my left going the third and last time. That's your brother over here.
Oh, yes,
that's your brother. There's another one here. Right, another one by Arthur again. There's a good one this time. That last one was scrap. Any offers for this photograph here? Frame photograph here, much? Any offers? It's about half the size. Andrew, a tenner. Surely, £10 I'm offered. £10 on my left now for the frame photograph. £10, frame by Arthur Gervin. £10 down here, any more? Any advance in 10? £10. £10 going once. 12 anywhere. 10 going 12. £12, John, Andrew. Oh, 15. 15, John, £20. £20 in the middle. 20 going once. £20 going once. £20 going twice. 20 going the third and last time, John Baird. Now a meal for four. A meal for four in the Kilmurry Arms. Confirm what?
Four, number
40. Eric Niblock, is Eric there? Eric, is this for four or for 40? Four, right, four. Preferably with people with bad appetites and ulcers and stuff. Any overs now for a meal for four in the Kilmurry Arms? Any overs? 20. £20 on my left. £20 on my left now for a meal for four in the Kilmurry Arms. £20, 25, 30 behinds, 35. Where? Any more? 35's in here, Lou. £40 on, £40 in the middle. £40, that's one meal. £40 here, 40 in the middle going once. £40, the bid's in here now, all in here in the middle. 42, 45, 45 in the middle again. At £45 going once. £50 away over my left. That you, Brian? £50 on my left, £50 going once. 52, 55, £55, £60,
Not anymore, Brian. 60 here in the middle. 60 pounds going once, 60 going two, 62, 65, 65 in the middle again at 65 going once, 65 going twice in the middle, 70 pounds. 70 pounds to the left. 70 pounds going once, twice. He is all done. Brian Hunter. Brian Hunter now for that. Meal for two in the Kilmurray, or in the Canal Court. Meal for two in the Canal Court. A much more romantic setting. Any overs for it? Any of them do you all? Any overs for it? 30. 30 pounds here in the middle for two. 30 pounds, 30 pounds, you get 32. 35. 35, 40 pounds. 42. 42 pounds, 42. 42 in the middle for the meal for two in the Canal Court at 42 going once. 45. 45 pounds out in the middle at 45. 50 pounds. 50 pounds away right now at 50. 50 pounds going once, 50 pounds going twice, 50 away on my right going the third and last time. Is that Gregory? No, who was it? What she is? Hello? One of you two, you can take Harold with you, Gregory. And now a meal for two in the Aylesford House. Any overs for it? Oh, go ahead, you'll get a bite someplace. 20 pounds here in the middle. 20 pounds, 20 pounds, the Aylesford House. 20 pounds going once, 20 pounds in the middle, two, Robert, 25, Robert again, 30 pounds, 32, 35, 37, 40 pounds, 42, 45, 47, 50 pounds, 50 pounds, these meals are getting dearer, 50 pounds on my left going once, 50 pounds over on my left twice, 50 going the third and last time, Robert McCullough. What's this? Number 14. Setting of 20 photos, colour or black and white or mixed plus, 1, 12 by 16 enlargement, enlargement dry mounted, heat sealed and framed by Ebony Picture Framing. Contact Christine at wherever. Child's portrait. Any overs for it? Any overs including the frame? Any all you supplies the child? The rest of it's all done for you. Any overs? Any overs for this here? Any overs? William, you have plenty of youngsters to take photographs. Much? A fiver. £5. Thank you, William. £5 in the... Oh, 10. That's Raymond now, William. You see him. £10. £10 out behind here now. £10. £10 going once. 10, 12, 15 down away at the back. 17... Lorraine, 20 away at the back again. Lorraine, where are you at? 22. Doran, 25. 25, what do you think? No. £25 away at the back going once. Huh? 30. 30. Wait. Uh-oh. £30 here I'm getting. 35. 30, 40. 5. 50. 5. 60. 5. 70. 5, 75, 80, 80, 90, 90 pounds on my right now, 90, going at 90 pounds, 90, 90 pounds going once, 90 pounds going twice, 90, 100, 100, 100, Rosemary, the bits away behind that, 100 pound going once, 100 pound going twice, 100 and 10, 110 on my right now, Darren, you've had it, 110 on my right going once, 110 going twice, 110 going the third and last time, Rosemary Chestnut. 12 pounds going once, 15, 15, 20, 20 pounds, 20 pounds going once, 20 going twice, 20 going the third and last time, Jackie Moore.
We'll keep you close. myself.